All right, so in this video, we're gonna show you how to tight mic a tom. We're gonna show you a two mic technique for doing both the top and the bottom to get a really full body sound. All right, so we're gonna show you how to mic some toms. Now, the most common microphones you're going to encounter are the Sennheiser 421 and the Shure SM57. Today we have a very big sounding kit, so we're gonna want a little larger diaphragm, so we're gonna go with the Sennheiser 421. All right, so like anything else, you're going to want to experiment with where the mic is on the tom to get the best sound. I'm just going to show you some common placements for it and tell you what kind of sound you're gonna get. So most importantly, you wanna make sure that the mic is out of the way of the player. Nothing ruins a tom take like you smacking the mic. So you can sort of just experiment with the distance it is from the center. As a general rule, the more it is aimed toward the center, you're gonna get a lot more stick noise. And the more it is aimed toward the back, you're gonna get less stick and more of that boomy kind of sound. So once again, play with the movement and see what you like. So another trick to getting really, really big sounding toms is to actually mic the bottom. Now, of course, when you mic the top and the bottom of something, these mics are going to be out of phase. So you have to make sure that either in Pro Tools, your recording software, or on your board, you flip the phase of one of the mics, usually the bottom. So the important thing when using the bottom mic is to make sure that it's 180 degrees out of phase with the top, so that when you do the phase flip, it's all gonna be nice and in phase and nice and full sounding. It's actually counterproductive if they are out of phase because then you're gonna get a thin sound. So what you wanna do is just make sure you match the angle, whether it's on a 45 degree or straight up and down, so that you can get that full boominess out of your tom.